I was a young coach once, young children up 3, 4, 5 o'clock in the morning, like all of us with sick babies. Doesn't matter, you got practice the next day, you gotta be on. Every day you have to be ready to have your best practice of the year. I was talking to Ray and Steph last night. The years in Oklahoma, if you're a college coach and you take your team into the NCAA tournament, you have between 103 and 110 practice days. Between 103 and 110. Whatever that number is, you better have great energy, great focus. There's days when you may have a little levity in practice, make jokes, whatever. But whatever your identity is, your practice better reflect it. Your point guard better embrace your vision. Your best player better be an ally and not hold you hostage. And it doesn't matter what level. Our best player for Milwaukee Bucks is big Australian by the name of Andrew Bogut. I've been with him for 2 years. I've never seen him have a bad practice. He's the same way every single day. I've been kissed by Eduardo Nahala at Oklahoma for 4 years. I was surprised. And I can go on and on to every team I've had. If we were good that year, it had a lot to do with our point guard and our best player buying into the vision of the program. And that is not negotiable. Most teams have underachieved at poor player leadership. That's not an opinion. That's a fact. You think of a team that you've coached or you've coached again that has all this talent, and you say, why can't that team win? Why is that team underachieving? When a coach is going to get blamed, that's just the way things work. But most teams underachieve because they have poor player leadership. And you have to figure out how to solve that problem. Early on in my coaching career, I figured out how I would like for my teams to play. I was a head coach in college when I was 25. It's a bad job. Hard job. Impossible job in some ways. That's probably why I got it. I wanted to get a good one, so I had to get a hard job, a tough job. So I had to be creative in figuring out how we can compete with these better teams. So we came up with a system. We came up with an identity for our program. We have to be tougher physically, we have to be tougher mentally. We've got to find a way to get our kids to play harder and compete. And understand this, and I guess I'm talking to the younger coaches now. There's a huge difference in playing hard versus competing. Huge difference. Don't think playing hard is the best you can do. Competing. The difference in playing hard versus competing is the scoreboard. There's a winner and a loser. Somebody's going to win the game. Guys that play hard sometimes, winning and losing is not as important to them. They just play hard because that's what they're expecting. For the last 2 weeks, I've watched our guys in Milwaukee play pickup games. We always play 7 or 8 pickup games. We play the bypasses. The last game is just 7. You got to win by 2. But over the course of the first 4 or 5 games, it's amazing to me how many guys don't know what the score is. They don't know what's the score. They don't know what's the score. How can you not hold the score? You're competing, right? Those kind of guys are always driving nuts. How can you not hold the score, right? Trying to win the game, right?